underway. Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by the jump.
Oh, beautiful jab by him there, really taking advantage of what is an obvious edge and reach.
Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this one?
Oh, a nice punch out of the break there after he had caught the leg. So he is really starting to put it all together now and clearly seems to have found the timing of his opponent.
Caught that. Now there's danger in that too, because when you start reaching out to catch that kick, you come the high kick, then you're in a lot of trouble.
Diaz's strike there is blocked. Nice job by the defense. Try to establish that jab. Oh, how about the transition to the ankle pick? Now we will see where he goes from here.
Got the ankle pick. Let's see how he advances from this position.
Trying to establish that jab once again.
Leg kick.
All right, he engages in the single collar tie.
Big power punch lands. Now he gets back to range.
Just out of range with that right hook.
He's throwing every part of himself into these big leg kicks.
Oh, beautiful slip and counter there by Diaz. Oh, nice offering there with the knee. He talked to us a lot about that on Thursday. Felt like the knees would be there. It was certainly there on that exchange.
He knew they would be available. He just knew he would have to find the right opportunity and right time to land those strikes.
And they separate. You wonder if the offensive fighter's gonna start to get frustrated here. Most skipped on all these shots are getting blocked.
They're getting blocked because he's fighting one of the best defensive fighters in the UFC. Oh, that was a big takedown. Is this the one that's gonna break him?
It's the elbow there. All right, we'll see how he chooses to defend here. Oh, big combination of ground and pound strikes here, DC. This could be the beginning of the end.
I mean, you gotta be very careful.
Oh, pretty good entry there, and he gets the fight to his wheelhouse on the ground.
Beautiful takedown into the full guard. Look for him to posture and use ground and pound to open up submission opportunities. Big kick.
Doesn't gain top position.
What a beautiful takedown, but he just waited for 1 second, and his opponent reacted before he could secure top position.
Starting to do some really significant damage to the body here. Another strike lands there. Got the single collar tie.
Look at him yank the head and land that beautiful punch from the clinch. He's very tricky when he throws that body kick.
Flips. 5 minutes in the books. All right, let's take a look back at some of the replays from that last round.
Unbelievable to see.
All right, second round now underway. I'm no analyst, but a little bit of a feeling out process there in round one.
And that's a part of being in the octagon with someone that's so skilled. You cannot just go after guns blazing. Most of these young men are trying to find the right moment to attack.
Another strike. Oh, yeah. Found that punch right there. His opponent's compromised, DC.
It's one thing to land a hard shot. It's another thing completely to land a perfect shot. And that was a perfect shot.
DC, didn't take him long to find his range here tonight, huh?
His timing is on point.
Oh, straight right. Oh, big knee to the body. How'd he get that one home? His opponent stayed upright.
I mean, he's still on his feet, but he's not up by much.
Body. And now he lands a combination. Oh! Well, nice double leg takedown attempt there, and gotta think that's something that's gonna give him confidence moving forward in this fight.
A lot of confidence when it happens that easily. He took a shot, he got a takedown. What now will stop him from doing it over and over again?
Continuing to work out of the half guard. Look at the torso on the right side. Major bruising, and it's only getting worse. Oh, useful strike on the ground, that was.
He's putting him in exactly the positions he needs to be in right now. He's able to relax here. And he understands, being a veteran of so many fights, that as long as he's on top, he's winning. He feels like he's winning here.
And those knees aren't just for effect. Those are doing real damage. Oh, man, how is he standing? Brutal knee to the body. Back to the knee. Oh! Well, he continues to do a nice job here defensively protecting. All right, bottom fighter here, maybe looking to hip escape, DC.
Oh, this is where you don't want to be, though.
Tom, you are in a ground fighting situation with this fighter. You're potentially playing with fire. Oh, back up again. You can't hold a good man down. So how about that? Another takedown for the decorated striker. Are you surprised he keeps taking this fight to the ground, given how good his opponent is from that bottom position?
I'm a little bit surprised because it seemed like there are so many different ways to go and try to find victory instead of taking this approach. But
right.
He's doing it over and over again. You just gotta hope that it doesn't cost us.
10 minutes in the books. All right, there's the horn, and what a round it was for him, DC. And look at him walking back to that corner. He's feeling himself a little bit.
Oh, he's feeling himself. And look at his coaches. They're all celebrating because they know that if they stay the course, if they do the exact same thing, they may be able to find the finish this time.
Finish the round. Nice. Way to go. Listen, you almost had him finished, but the round came at the...
All right, so another round is now underway. Pretty good action over the previous 10 minutes. Your thoughts on what we might see here?
Both of the guys really picking up on the action. Put their foot on the gas and really starting to drive it home as we approach the end of the fight, and we're still so even.
Oh, the master of the transition. Nice grip. He closes the distance, gets the single collar tie. A couple of uppercuts there for good measure. Oh, and he connects there. His hands look good to him.
So fast. I mean, this guy has tremendous hand speed.
Nice knee to the midsection there. Gets tagged again on the inside. Diaz's lower jaw does not look good. I don't think it's broken, but starting to show some obvious signs of swelling.
Gets to his spot, the tie clinch. Then he starts to let the knees fly.
And now he's got the tie clinch. Oh, these are some impactful knees he's throwing, and I guess until his opponent adjusts, might as well keep throwing them.
He's gonna keep going to the well. Why would he change it? His opponent has not been able to figure out these knees.
Oh, significant strike attempt there, but a huge block. A little single collar tie there. Judo throw. Let's see if he can capitalize and lock up a sub.
You gotta try to find whether or not you're gonna land ground and pound here or if you're gonna go to submission.
Trying to guard pass here. Not today.
No, it ain't happening. Good job understanding the transition.
Oh, man. This ground and pound is good. Probably my favorite striking realm in MMA, and he's as good as it gets.
The problem is his opponent is not controlling his posture. He's allowing his opponent to get up, and when he does, he creates this.
Look at him, he's setting up the choke now. Look at that, he's setting it up.
Gotta get up. Nicely done. Elbow landed there by Diaz. Oh, wow, that happened quickly as the fighter reverses position there on the ground.
Unbelievable position change. Position.
Strong bottom work here, staying busy. All right, it's a good ground and pound by him here, certainly staying busy, and not just busy, but effective.
You can just throw punches to keep the referee off you. This guy is throwing punches to be effective, to throw damaging strikes. He's doing a fantastic job.
Posturing up now.
And now the damage is about to start.
He's trying to control posture here. Now trying to hip escape.
He's just trying to move out of this position up the bottom. Now look at him jumping in to try to get the finish.
Close guard. Oh, he postured up there, gained some valuable separation.
And now, the ground and pound starts.
Oh, nice work from the bottom. Tags him with the punch. That's three rounds in the can. We're headed to the championship rounds. All right, let's check out some of the action. Making good use of his reach advantage there with that punch. All right, he'll engage in a single collar tie.
Look at him drive his shin into the opponent's body with that body kick.
Diaz's lower jaw looking extremely swollen now.
He's in trouble. He's hurt bad.
Big knee to the body. I can't think of a worse place in the world to be when you are tired than the world-famous Octagon. We got two fighters who are nearly gassed out here, champ.
Both of them are exhausted, and they are questioning what they did wrong in preparation for this fight. Or did they get in the Octagon and just go crazy? You gotta manage the cardio if you're gonna be able to fight a long fight.
Oh, that uppercut is nasty. How do you defend it? Oh, he got that knee to connect to the body, and if you're the defensive fighter here, you got to make sure you don't eat too many more of those.
You cannot eat too many. You got to get the elbows to try, and otherwise, you're going to land one that's going to shut everything down.
All right, so maybe he goes for another takedown here, and it's the setups, too, right? He's not blindly shooting from the outside. Maybe he'll get him down again.
He's doing a fantastic job of setting up his takedown with his hands. He's forcing the hands up around to block his face, and then he's dropping his level, shooting his shots. And ultimately, oh, he just hurt him, he just hurt him.
Back to the feet now.
Oh! He needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad. He is getting good ups right now, John.
Unbelievable. And that'll do it!
Oh! What a fight!
Again, the winner here was so aggressive with his onslaught. He wanted to make sure he kept the judges out of the equation. Mission accomplished on that front as he gets the TKO victory here tonight.